Alberto, Amen Abuji. Also, we have Al-Aziz, Castle of Six Words. Also, we have our best counseling woman of the fourth ward, Ruby Cotton. And last but least, we got two in Rio, the councilman of the fifth ward, Luis Velez. Sound better than Morris.
Let me just say thank you for everybody for coming out. As you can see that I have my DJ here, Deshaun, who's been with me, but for many of you, you've been with me for a long time. And I can tell you, this is year number 39. Year number 39. And I say, as long as that I can do this, I'm gonna do this. And so I'm just happy for everybody who came out to help volunteer. I got your name on the list, but we're ready to serve the food. I mean, it's a grab and go, but what I want, my friend here in the fourth ward, Reverend Irving, to please come up and say a prayer.
Thank you, Ruth. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Everybody ought to praise the Lord. Somebody ought to give God a praise on this day. Somebody ought to bless his holy name. In spite of everything that is going on, God is yet good, and he's worthy. I said he's worthy to be praised. I know y'all ready to eat, but I just want to share a thought with you. First, we give honor to God, who is the head of my life. I give honor to our councilwoman, Ruby Cotton, and to the Greer family, to our mayor, and to all the council people that are here. And I greet you, all my father's children, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It does my heart good to see so many people that are out this afternoon, especially the young people. I know y'all ready to eat. If you just give me a minute, I'll get out your way. Especially the young people that are here this afternoon. All of the vendors that are outside, everyone that is participating in this blessed occasion. It is truly a blessed occasion to have the young people that are helping us today. Be with somebody. Grab somebody here. Touch and agree. Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus, we come boldly to your throne of grace on this afternoon. And Lord, we ask you that you forgive us of our sins. But Father, we want to say thank you for this day, a day that we have never seen before, but it's a day that you have allowed us to be here. We thank you, Father, for life, health, and strength today. Lord, we thank you for our councilwomen and those that are in charge today. We thank you for another year that you have kept us. We thank you for this Thanksgiving day. And Father, I look towards heaven this afternoon. And I'm asking you, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus, not by power nor by might, but by your spirit on this afternoon, oh God, that you will move in a mighty way, oh God, that you will touch every young folk that came up here today, that you will bless them, that you will keep them, that you will cover them with your blood, even as they stand on the corner, even as they walk the street, even as they go to school. Cover them with your blood right now in the name of Jesus. I speak life in their body, and I speak healing in their life. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, do it for them. Do it for them right now, oh God. Do it for them right now. Forgive them of their wrong. Forgive them of their shortcoming, oh God. Forgive them and have mercy on them, oh God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, I declare and I decree it according to your word. This day, a radical change is going to change in every young folk life that has came up here today. That they are going to leave this place not the way that they came in, but they're going to change. They're going to be obedient to their mother. They're going to be obedient to their father. As you said in your word, oh God, that they days may be long upon this land, oh God. Rebuke the devout that wish to destroy them right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you. I said we thank you for every youth that are in this building. We thank you, oh God, for every youth that are in this building today. And we bless your holy name. Bless the mood, the food that we're about to receive. Bless the hand that prepared that may be nourishment in our body, that it may sanctify our soul. We ask you all these blessings in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the precious Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Put your blessed hands together and give God a praise for this.
The former mayor and current councilwoman from the fourth ward, Ruby N. Cotton.
We have so much to be thankful for. Thankful for our family. We're thankful for our friends. We're thankful for God giving us another opportunity to celebrate each other. But I want to ask the question, around 4:30, who's going to emerge victorious? The New York Giants or the Dallas Cowboys? I think the Giants have it. We'll be enjoying our turkey. And remember, a vote for Ruby Cotton means you'll never be forgotten. Let's hear it for Ruby, 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 Ruby.
Thank you, Mayor, thank you. But I just want to say too, I'm not sure who's faithful to God, but Councilwoman Vera Ames started this 39 years ago. I've been with her for at least 20 of those years. So I just want to say, as long as I have breath in my life, in my body, I'm going to continue to do this for our community, because it's about doing it for our community. God bless you all, for everybody that came out to help me. Everybody. I love you all. My church, everybody. So with that being said, we got some seniors waiting for their meal.
That's right.
I got about 150 senior dinners I need to deliver. So God bless you all, and thank you again. Hit it, Mr. DJ.
The mayor of the city of Paterson. How you doing?
I express my gratitude to my former colleague and the former mayor and current councilman for the 4th Ward, the Honorable Ruby Ann Cotton, today providing meals for the less fortunate. But she's also been supportive in helping us restore Hinchcliffe Stadium, bringing a visitor center to the Great Falls, improving four different fields, and championing four different affordable housing projects here in the city of Paterson. Couldn't have made it possible without also the support of our 5th Ward Councilman, Louis A. Velez. Louis Velez, take over.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a great day today. Give back, give thank you to those that always cooperate with our city and let move the city forward. We are happy, happy that you live in Paterson, because Paterson is going to move forward to another dimension. With your help, I will help with the blessing of God. Thank you, Elder Durham, all the work that you do to try to keep the community informed and to keep us together. God bless you all.
God bless you.